there's always been a difference between who's experiencing concentrated poverty broken down by race. But over the past 20 years, we've seen almost a 900% increase in Latinx families who are living in concentrated poverty neighborhoods. And so what we find now is that people of color, families of color, regardless of their income, so regardless of whether they're experiencing poverty or not, are more likely than than white North Carolinians to live in those neighborhoods. So, you know, the reality is that no matter whether or not you have enough income to keep you above poverty, no matter whether or not you're doing the things that we've asked you to do, whether you're getting an education, you're doing all these things, people of color are more likely to live in these neighborhoods that are underinvested, that don't have the resources that that they need in order to thrive.
And it's a vicious circle, needless to say, right, that absolutely. Then results. And you've got actually county by county data, I believe, in this report, right? If folks want to get online and check
it
out.
Yeah, so you should absolutely check and see where your county lies and how many high poverty neighborhoods there are in your county. And then we also show a comparison between 2000 and 2016, so you can see if your county has grown, if it's done better, and kind of where that growth is happening in the state.
We'll say at the end for folks to check out the report. But I do want to focus on, some of the things maybe that we can do about this. I mean, we're not completely at the mercy of the winds of fortune here. There's things that public structures and government can do about it. There are possibilities for intentional public solutions to address these problems. What are some of the things that you identify that we ought to be doing?
Well, one of the first things is that we need to make sure that people who work are able to make a living. And so, right. But we need to, part of that is increasing the minimum wage. North Carolina, as of 2014, had the second highest rate of the working poor in the entire nation. So one of the first solutions is making sure that people actually have a living wage. Another thing that we can do is to invest in infrastructures in our communities that allow people to get to where they need to go, that we're investing in our schools, that we're investing in these critical public structures that help to alleviate some of the double burden that people are experiencing. And the last thing I'll say is that we have to recognize the policies that created these issues. We have to move away from the narrative that people are living in these neighborhoods as a result of their own failings or a result of their own decisions. And we have to recognize that this is a creation of public policy and that we're going to have to pass policies, racially conscious policies, in order to actually alleviate these issues.